بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says تلك الرسل تلك الرسل فضلنا بعضهم على بعض. These are the messengers we have favored some over the others. This is a continuation of Surah Al-Baqarah, and this is the last juz or para in which we have Surah Al-Baqarah. As we mentioned before, Surah Al-Baqarah is the longest surah of the Quran, and it covers almost three juz or three paras of the Quran. In this para, in this juz, we have the greatest ayah of the Quran. The greatest verse of the Quran, and that is Ayatul Kursi, Ayat Al Kursi. And this is the greatest ayah or verse of the Quran, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us. And for us to sit down and memorize this verse and reflect over its meanings is of great benefit. In fact, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in various ahadith, it is a protection. Ayatul Kursi is a protection from shaitan and a protection from evil. It is to be recited at various times, such as after each obligatory salah and before going to sleep, for example. After that, in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us or mentions to us various stories. The story of Ibrahim alayhi salam with Nimrud and that conversation that took place between them. You also have the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show him how does Allah revive the dead, and Allah's response to him. And after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions various ayat dealing with the importance of charity, of sadaqah. And so there are many, many verses that come towards the end of Surah Al-Baqarah that encourage us to give, to spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to make sure that our intentions are sincere and pure for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that we do not, cause our charity to become invalidated through having wrong intentions. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions to us in the same verses the danger of riba, and that is interest or usury, and how, the one who involves himself in riba, it is as if he has waged war with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then towards the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, we have the longest verse in the Quran, the longest ayah and verse in the Quran, which is known as Ayatul Dain, or the verse of borrowing or lending, of loaning money. And in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the rulings pertaining to how to go about lending money, and how it should be written down, and there should be witnesses, and so on and so forth. And then after that, we have the last three verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, which are also very important verses. In these verses, we have du'a, where we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness and for his mercy. And these last verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that the one who recites it at night before going to sleep, they will be sufficient for him, meaning they will act as a protection for him until the morning. And with that, we conclude Surah Al-Baqarah. Moving on to the next surah in the same juz, in the same para, that is Surah Ali Imran. Surah Ali Imran is also a very, very large surah, and it comes right after Surah Al-Baqarah. Ali Imran, or the family of Imran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts off the surah by once again talking about the Qur'an and how the Qur'an contains ayatun muhkamat, clear-cut verses, wa ayatun mutashabihat, or the not-so-clear verses. And Allah talks about those who believe in both of these kinds of verses. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about in Surah Ali Imran various things until we reach the story of Imran, the family of Imran, and the wife of Imran, who basically gave birth to Maryam, who is the mother of Isa alayhi salam. So we have the story of Imran, the father of Maryam, and how, you know, the wife of Imran gave birth to Maryam, and then also how Maryam gave birth to Isa alayhi salam. And so, as Allah says, that they are offspring one of another. They are, one family, righteousness after righteousness passed on one after the other. And we also have the mention of Zakariya, who took care of Maryam. And as I mentioned, we have the story of Maryam giving birth to Isa alayhi salam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Isa alayhi salam and how he was sent as a prophet, a messenger for Bani Israel. And what happened, there were among his followers those who he felt that they are starting to disbelieve. فَلَمَّا أَحَسَّ عِيسَى مِنْهُمُ الْكُفَرُ قَالَ مَنْ أَنْصَارِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. He started to feel that, these people are starting to disbelieve in me. So he took for himself, followers and companions who supported him. Until, Allah talks about how he told Isa alayhi salam that we will protect you, that Allah will protect you and raise you up to him subhanahu wa ta'ala without any harm touching you from your enemies. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the rest of the surah, talks about the Christians, and there's a dialogue that takes place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to address Ahlul Kitab and to basically debate with them about the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the truth of Isa alayhi salam. And, you find throughout these verses, there are, many, many lessons that can be derived and, points that we can use in our da'wah to the Christians, inviting them to Tawheed and, proving to them the invalidity of the Trinity and, attributing a son to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.